Hi, I'm Caleb. I'm a junior. I grew up here in actually just this house. I've lived here all my life. It's a family of five, my mom, my dad, and I have two brothers. And this is me. My dad is a photographer. He does that freelance. That's his business. He actually has his own photography business where he'll go and do event photography at like weddings and sports games, concerts, things of all natures. And so I've always kind of taken after him, found an interest in the technical aspects of all that, and just kind of picked it up. And I work with him occasionally on events, whether it's running a photo booth or taking photos. And it's kind of blossom into its own thing. I really do like taking photos as an art thing and as a creative outlet, and so it partially is a hobby, but I also do it on the side for and be hired to make money for it. Usually I'm behind the camera, not in front of it. How has Jared been? So when I go on photo shoots, whether it's doing senior photos or events or whatever, he'll help and be my little helper, I guess, an assistant. So he'll, you know, hold up maybe a reflector or whatever, whatever piece of equipment I need him to do on the side, or he'll help me set up a shot. So he's slowly, as he becomes more experienced with that, becomes a larger role in the photography sessions.
Do you think you're like the most important role, kind
yes,
of?
Yes, obviously. Yeah.
Okay. I control the sun.
He controls all the lighting. He's what makes all this happen. If it weren't for him, no photos. Forget the camera, forget the photographer. Jared's what matters.
No, watch this. Look at this.
What is your prize picture or like your best picture?
So there's two that I'm kind of caught between. One is of a pyramid in Chichen Itza in Mexico. And then I have another one where I was in Hawaii snorkeling, and I like to do underwater photography too, which is pretty fun. But I saw this turtle come up for air. So it was pretty much just at the surface, and I dove underneath and got a shot from below with the light peeking through, just kind of having the silhouette of the turtle and the reflections in the surface of the water and everything. I could see myself doing it for potentially the rest of my life. It's just some creative outlet that I have, a hobby, which I don't see going away. It's just something fun I do, as well as sometimes make a bit of money off of it. Most of my piano skills are self-taught. I learned very, very, very basic stuff from my guitar teacher. And when I first bought my piano, he would teach me how you're supposed to put your hands on the keys and just small things like that. And from that point on, I could just use that and just through playing and trying to, you know, listening to music and trying to figure out how to play those songs on the keyboard or a piano, I'd be able to. You know, I've just gotten better and better at playing it. Biggest music instruments. Oh man, I could go on for hours about this. Primary one at the moment is Brian Wilson. He's the main songwriter and composer for the Beach Boys. But a lot of people associate them with just their early 60s, like surf pop, you know, writing about cars and girls and stuff. But towards the mid-60s and past that, he demonstrated a lot of musical complexity through inspirations like jazz and classical music, and put out one of the most influential albums of all time, Pet Sounds. And it's been like a huge, huge inspiration to me. Typically, a lot of times it's a creative outlet for me. So if I'm, you know, stressed out or, you know, I just feel some sort of inspiration or motivation to go and sit down, I'll do that. I'll sit down at the piano and just kind of I'll first play a couple chords and just kind of float around the keys to kind of figure out, you know, where I want to start. And once I find a chord I like or that kind of fits that mood that I'm feeling, that's the key that I play in. And then it just kind of comes to you. It's not like something you actively think about. It's just, okay, I played this chord. I feel like I want to play this chord, so I'm going to go here. I want to go up the keys or down the keys. Or, you know, it just kind of comes to you. So, yeah. I was actually sitting in my computer science class last year, and I saw that deal come up on Craigslist, and immediately I'm like, that's the one I want to get. That is the thing I've been looking for. That's the exact condition, the exact price that I'm looking for. And so I texted the guy immediately and got into contact with him. I've always liked old Beatles and VWs since I was a kid. Around 15 or 16, when I was starting to look into getting my license and looking for cars that I might need, one thing that popped in my mind was maybe getting an old car and trying to restore it. And so I just kind of worked towards that goal and eventually got there. I got it in sort of running but not driving condition, and it was kind of like that for up until August, I guess. And I'd say 5 months after I originally purchased it, did it finally get out onto the road. It's a 1966 VW Beetle. It's a one-year-only model engine, and actually a one-year-only car with a lot of one-year-only parts. A lot of the research and the know-how on the car, I've just had to research and read books and search online forums and all of these different sources to figure out what I was doing on the car. But when I'm actually working on the car and I need a couple extra hands, primarily Jared has been a big help on it, and also my dad has been a big help. You know, as slow as it is and as kind of messed up as it is in some areas, it's just charming. It's got like, it's got the character, it's got this own like spirit. So, you know, I can wake up in the morning, you know, not be in the best of moods, or, you know, come out of a bad day of school and get in that car and, you know, just go on a drive, and it's just, I don't know, whatever I'm nervous about or whatever I'm upset about just disappears.